Hi there guys, it's Ross at FoodTravelMusicLove.com, inspiration from the heart. We are in the ASHDOWN FOREST today at the brilliant group-friendly ROEBUCK Hotel with this brilliant selection of local farm food. Let's see. Today we've been out and about and visited three local farm shops in the ASHDOWN FOREST, something quite close to my heart. I always try and promote, as you'll know if you've seen my videos, local produce, getting out, eating local. I'm going to try and do a little bit of eating local today. A couple of bits I've never tried before, so raw milk for example, supposed to be good for the gut, can go the other way. We're currently sat in the ASHDOWN suite of the Roebuck Hotel, just outside Forest Row in East Sussex. This is a really, really good hotel, really, really good for groups down here. I'm down here promoting that, and I'm also down here promoting three fantastic local farm shops. First off, I visited the TABLEHURST Community Farm Shop. Brilliant place, massive, massive grounds, just off the A22 that was. You have to drive up a nice long big driveway, and then you can see all the vegetables and things growing out there. They had a nice outdoor cafe as well. You'll see there's an indoor cafe, there's an outdoor cafe area. Brilliant place. I really, really like that there. Nice setting. On a good day, everything looks good, but that looked especially good there on a good day. Their fruit and veg selection there was absolutely fantastic. One of the best ones I've seen. Really, really nice outdoor selection. Everything looks fresh, nothing looking anything out of place. Just what the doctor ordered that. I'm gonna get on and try a couple of these bits. Plough Hatch Farm, biodynamic, unpasteurized raw milk. I've never had raw milk in all my life. I'm going for the whole version, whole milk. They did have semi-skimmed. They had loads of yogurts. They had loads of cheeses all made with this stuff as well. This was really, really good. Plough Hatch, I really, really enjoyed that place there. They were very accommodating, very friendly. As you can see, they let me show you their cheese shop. Really, really nice, massive big round cheeses. Haven't seen that sort of thing since I used to read comic books and things when I was a kid, so it was great to see that actually there being made on site. I'm gonna have some of this while it's still nice and cool. I haven't opened a pint of milk like this for 26 years. Oh, bursting out, okay. This is, may seem a strange thing to be reviewing, but raw milk is something I've never tried before, and people have told me it's quite different to pasteurised milk, so let's see. Oh, that is really, really nice. That tastes proper naughty. This is the whole milk version. Just tastes so much more natural and fresh and organic, everything that it should be. Oh, that is as good as out of the cow, into the glass, into the mouth. That is exactly how I'd like that. I'm going to try this beautiful cake made by Holly. Oh, that is absolutely stunning. Brilliant. That was from TABLEHURST. You could get these at a couple of the others as well. Holly lives on site at TABLEHURST. Ah, so, so naughty. We then moved on to the Plough Hatch Farm Shop. Smaller setting, smaller venue than at TABLEHURST, but I think a better, bigger selection there. I like the venue and the setting of the other one, but the selection I think was a lot more diverse at the Plough Hatch. That was really, really nice that. These chilies are possibly the most expensive chilies I've ever bought. Bear in mind, a lot of my work has been in Asia, and in Asia, these three chilies would cost about 4p, literally, by weight. These chilies cost me £2.10, so quite expensive. From the TABLEHURST place, this is quite expensive produce. It said Spanish on there. Now, I'm not actually sure whether it means they are Spanish seeds and then grown on site, which I assume, or whether they're imported from Spain. Seems to be unnecessary with the amount of land that they've got there. Organic. If you've seen any of my videos in the past, you'll know that just eating raw chilies is a bit of a thing to me. Of course, if you're watching, a bit of a disclaimer, Please be careful, don't eat raw chilies. I'm gonna try one of these chilies from TABLEHURST. Expensive chilies, let's see what they're like. I'm gonna try one of these with these that came from Plough Hatch. The Plough Hatch farm seemed really, really nice. I really, really enjoyed that there. This actually isn't direct produce from there, but it's the same ethos, buy organic snacks and you can get them there. I've never heard of these before, Trafo, so let's just find them what they're like anyway. Literally, you've tuned in to watch a man eating crisps. YouTube's for anything. Yeah, they're nice. I'm not sure if you're supposed to taste the bio-organic difference compared to kettle or Tyrrell, but they're very good. This was £1, so quite a lot for a small bag. They are nice, they are nice. I'd definitely take those all day long over a bag of Walkers, especially because of what they represent. Chili time. I think these are gonna just be, they didn't have any spice level on there, they just said chilies. These to me, in my experience, seem to be like standard medium red chilies. They're clearly a red chili, but a lot of chilies are red. Some of them are just called red chilies, green chilies, medium chilies. I think this is what we're gonna get. Let's go for the big one. Let's have a look. This is normal. Oh, I love it. Oh. Yeah, I'm getting the burn. That's a nice, strong heated medium chili. If it looks weird, me smell it. I think you should do that. You should smell, you should feel, get the taste, get a little bit of everything about anything that you're eating. People think I'm odd for doing that. No, enjoy it, embrace it. It's been put in front of you, or you've bought it, you paid money for it. Take every little bit of it in. Or just don't eat your raw chili. This is a common snack for me in the evening. Couple of crisps with a chili. Please comment if you ever do this yourselves. Am I the only one that does this? I like the combination of the kind of the spiciness with the crunchiness. Oh yeah, yeah. Oh, that's nice. Now these are, it's getting spicier, this, as it gets further down towards a stalk. I think that's normal. A lot of people think it's the seeds at the spicy bit, but it's not actually. It's kind of the membrane and the bits offshoot from the membrane of it. The outside bit should always be a little bit milder than what's going on the inside. If it's anything like my ex, certainly what was going on the inside was 10 times worse than the outside. Really, really nice organic chilies, those. I couldn't particularly taste much difference between those and some of the other ones that I've had before in terms of value for money, but they're organic, they're there, they're farm, they're really, really nice. And I always think support local farmers. This is what these videos are about. Support your local farmers, support your local farm shops. Please, please get out there and do that. More expensive, but you get better quality for more money. Simple as that. On to an intensely hot chili inferno. Nothing else about it at all particularly, just says intensely hot chili inferno sauce stroke dip. I'm gonna be using it as a dip. Oh, yep, that's gone right up the nostrils. That'll sort out COVID at 10 paces. As I've got these beautiful crisps open, I think it'd be rude not to try this as a crisp dip. Intensely hot chili inferno sauce. Let's see. Flavour's nice, really, really nice. It's like a tomato chutney. I'm gonna have to have a little bit more of that, which is quite a shame, because I'm not sure I can particularly taste the inferno, if I'm honest. I mean, my palate's not the best one for this, really. Okay. Beautiful, beautiful flavours. That's amazing flavour, I tell you what. If I had a loaf of bread here, it would go really well with the salumi. As random as that is, that's what I'm gonna do. I'm gonna try a little bit of the salumi, which was from the Plough Hatch farm. I'm gonna try a little bit of that with this intensely hot chili inferno, which, by the way, this came from Perryhill farm, Perryhill orchard, where this beautiful stuff here was from. Let's try a little bit of mix and match here. So that's all about, isn't it? Okay, oh, Oh, the smell of that halloumi. So this is called Sizzler. It's a Cypriot style brined cheese for cooking, suitable for grilling, frying and barbecuing, or tucking in to some intensely hot inferno sauce. So the cheese was from Plow Hatch. The sauce here was from Perryhill Orchard. We're gonna do a mix and match here. I'm gonna try it on its own first, of course. They called it Sizzler. I don't think they were allowed to call it halloumi. They had to change the name, apparently. It's really, really, really thick and sort of rubbery cheese. It's got an halloumi aroma to it. Very thick, wow. Oh. Oh, that is fantastic. Oh, grilling, frying and barbecue, yeah. I mean, that's really, really nice cold. So having that heated up, halloumi's not really something that melts particularly well. So it'd just be that with some intense smoky heat or something. Fantastic. Let's try it in here. Spicy halloumi cheese. Oh, what an what an amazing flavour combination that is. Halloumi cheese, Sizzler cheese, Cypriot, let's get it right. Apparently Cypriot style, halloumi cheese with the intensely hot chili inferno. Not amazingly hot for me, but a nice, nice flavour, nice kick to it. With that cheese, absolutely fantastic. You may be able to see here, this glass looks nice, ice cold, it certainly is. I'm gonna get my hand heat off it. I've had that full of ice, ready for the Perryhill Orchard's pear juice. Not something I often have. This was all made on site at Perryhill. Fantastic farm shop that, really, really enjoyed it there. Lovely tea room attached to it as well. You can have cider and juices on site, or you can take them away. I really, really like that style. Absolutely brilliant places. They let you do little tasters as well. Go easy on tasting. You could be here a long time and then you wouldn't be leaving. Dry scrumpy. I've got the car outside. Oh, that's nice, that. All over, you can see beautiful views all around. Out on the decking there, you can see some lovely views from the decking. Brilliant. Oh, yes. The click of a brand new bottle. Oddly enough, smells of pears. Okay. Perryhill Orchard's pear juice is pressed from orchard ripe pears grown in Kent and Sussex. Please visit our tea room and farm shop, which are open all year round. Fantastic. This was at Hartfield, East Sussex, Ashdown Forest. Cheers. Oh, that is so delicate. Oh, such a light, delicate flavours. I expected that to be bang, sugar, bang, like an apple juice is. Pears aren't like that. Oh, yes, very, very nice. Refreshing and not overpowering in any way with the flavour or with the sugar hit. You'll be right with this for diabetes, I'm sure. Oh, really, really nice product, that. Perryhill Orchard's pear juice, fantastic. Also from Perryhill's with that chili inferno sauce. That was in the village of Hartfield, which is only about 5 or 6 miles away from East Quinsteed, about 4 miles away from Forest Row. Beautiful part of the country, surrounded by Winnie the Pooh country, Winnie the Pooh forest. I kept looking out for Piglet everywhere, and didn't really find him, but is it him or her? It's a place I go.
Of God, see you as a desk and soul in the sand. sun. You just as silent as none. I'm young. It's a place I go when I'm alone. Do anything I want, be anyone I wanna be. It is a sight I see. I cannot believe I'm falling. It's a place I go.
See here, if you are turning up in a coach, absolutely no problem whatsoever with coach parking. It's got a really small car park at the front. Do not be deceived by that. Huge car park at the back here. To be fair, it's only got 28 rooms, so there's more than enough parking here for a car for every human that's staying here, plus a staff, plus a few coaches. This is really, really good to see. Fantastic big function room here, perfect for coach groups. They're really, really trying to encourage new coach tourism down here. You've got Winnie the Pooh area, you've got Sheffield Park, Lewis and Brighton. All the farm shops I visited were easily accessible by main roads, A roads, just outside of villages. Fantastic place this, ASHDOWN FOREST. I've really enjoyed it being here.